Hi guys, like we all know that we love making money while trading, and no one loves losing money in the markets. So there are various indicators, lots of indicators, lots of systems through which can make us get confused of how to trade and how to keep trade simple at a time when we keep on searching for various types of indicators which is would be simple and which would be a magic wand in our trading. Let me tell you that there is no magic wand, but if we trade this in a disciplined manner and have patience, we can make very decent amount of money from the markets. So in this regard, we will be discussing super trend, which is an indicator made of various moving averages, and let us not go into the technicalities, but let us discuss how to use this super trend for our benefit. Like you can see on most of the charting softwares, you have the super trend indicator which can be easily implemented and give you trading opportunities. Let me show you. Here we will be just selecting the super trend indicator and putting it on the chart, and it will be plotted automatically. The green and the red lines which you see is the trend line of the super trend. The green one indicates buy signals and the red one indicates sell signals. So what we will do, we will take a chart here. This is the chart of LLT, Larsen & Toubro. Let us see how it has worked. Here on 31st October, the super trend has given a buy indicator. Buy indicator means whenever it closes, moves above the red line, it is a buying signal. Means it forms a green line, and whenever it moves below this green line, it is a sell signal. So if you are an aggressive trader, you always are in a trade through super trend if you are using the super trend indicator. But in a trending market, if the market is a trending market, you can plan your trades accordingly. Say for example, we have got this buy signal on 31st October. Now we carry on this trade until the green line is broken and we get this red line, means we are stopped out here. There are various ways to add stop losses. One is you can just go into the trade and add stop losses by until the market starts making lower top lower bottoms when you have purchased. And if you have purchased it and the first lower top lower bottom comes over here, you can see there is a lower top lower bottom which comes on 21st of November. So your buying price is around, you say, 1282, and when you are stopped out, the price is around 1400. So you make a decent amount of money if you have gone into the trade. Or you can take this sell trade here when you get the sell signal on 14th of January and the market has taken the share price lower. So when you got a higher bottom over here, candle, so or here you got a higher top higher bottom, you are stopped out. This is one way of adding the stop loss. The other way is, you as soon as you take a trade, this is a daily chart, as soon as you take a trade in the daily chart, you just move to the hourly chart, and here on 31st we have taken the trade, and if you had carried the trade and until you are stopped out through the super trend indicator over here, you are into the trade and you make a decent amount of money. So the things to be taken care of here is that you just trade when you get a buy signal or you get a sell signal, and you carry the trade as long as you are not stopped out. Say for example, you are stopped out through the line. When the super trend is broken and the red line is formed, you can be stopped out this way. And all the time you carry this trade until it is broken on the closing basis, you carry this trade and you make the profits. If you are a daily trader, means if you are able to carry, have that risk appetite to carry overnight trades, then you can use the daily indicator. And if you are not having the risk appetite to carry on the trades overnight and in even months, basically in even months, and if there are geopolitical tensions, then the prices might open very low, or it can open very high, which can make a huge loss of capital. So you can trade on intraday basis also. You can use the hourly charts or 15 minutes charts. Let me plot the 15 minute charts. So in 15 minute charts, you should be very attentive to the indicator, and as soon as you are stopped out, you just move to the other side of the trade. So super trend is one classical indicator which keeps you always in the trade. Either you are on the sell side, either you are on the buy side of the market. So you are always in trade, and if you have patience and follow the rules and indicator, here you can make decent amount of money. So this is a very good trade with a very, this is a very simple indicator which you can give you very good amount of profits. And I would suggest you to have this indicator plotted on your charts and use it for trading. You can add other indicators along with it which can give you an additional benefit, but the signals in the super trend comes much faster than other indicators. And if the suppose if you are using MACD histogram and it combines with the super trend, then it can give you a very decent amount or a very good trade which can make you good profits, bring you good profits. So I would suggest you to use the super trend as your indicator, but work patiently and in a disciplined manner. Do not go against the trend indicator. It can make you incur losses. So as soon as you are stopped out, just book your losses and go into the next trade. As you can see in this chart, if you are even stopped out at times, still you can make good amounts of money. Over here, when you got the buy signal, if you have purchased, it would have taken you here. And the stop loss is one of the major thing which you need to concentrate on. A stop loss can be using the super trend line itself, or you can use a higher top, higher bottom as your stop loss. The first indication of a stop loss comes when the price is not able to sustain above its open. This is the first indicator. The second indicator is that when the price closes below the previous bar, in case of buy positions, when you are long in the market, and in case of short positions, when the market does not go below the open and it closes above the previous bar, it means that the market is in the process of bottoming out until and unless it gives a signal otherwise. So I hope this indicator and this video is useful to you, and if you find it useful, I would request you to like and subscribe for the video. I will be discussing more indicators and ways of trading in times to come. So please subscribe for this channel so that you are informed in advance. And at this time, while we are in a very confusing position in regards to which way the market is going to move, whether it is making a topping of formation here, or it is going to make a new high in the Nifty, which can be determined with only time to come. But one thing I can say is that the market is giving topping out signals. So trade carefully. Do not keep huge long positions overnight due to the event months ahead of us, and also the geopolitical tensions, which is cooled down, but the overseas market and the foreign markets are breaking down, and all the manufacturing data is coming below expectations. So trade carefully and use this indicator. It can give you good benefits. That's all for today. Thank you guys. Thanks for watching.